today we are going to start the new chapter of the class 10 science, that is carbon and its compounds. It is chemistry chapter. So now let us start with this chapter here. So about carbon, so we know that about the carbon, and carbon is a non-metal, right? So carbon is non-metal. So we know that in the periodic table, there is a classification of elements by Mendel's modern periodic table. So there are total 118 elements are there, in which 92 elements are metals and the most of 20 elements are water, non-metals. So in the non-metal, the one of metal is carbon, is a non-metal, and that is the symbol of carbon. You know the symbol of carbon, that is C, capital C is the symbol for carbon. And the atomic number of the carbon is, okay, the atomic number, of carbon is 6, right? The atomic number of carbon is 6, and if the atomic number of carbon is 6 means the configuration is, the electronic configuration is, that is electronic configuration is equal to 2 first orbit and the 4 is second orbit. How we write it? So in the 9th standard, you know about that one. So according to the Niels-Bohr's model of atoms, so one orbit, first orbit, must be have two electrons, completely free electrons, that is I write here 2. So I write here, this is the nucleus of the carbon, and this is the first orbit, that is called as only 2 electrons. Okay, it is stable, okay, doublet, stable. Now let us, now another 4 electrons are there, so we require another shell, so I can take another orbit or shell. So this is also the another orbit or shell having 4 electrons, okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4, right? So this is what the atomic structure of carbon. So there are 2 orbits are present in the carbon, okay? How many orbits are there? 2 orbits are there, okay? 2 orbits are present in the carbon. 2 orbits are present, right? 2 orbits are present, in which first orbit 2 electron and the last orbit, okay? First orbit 2 electron, 2 electrons, first orbit, okay, and the second orbit, or also we call it as an outermost orbit, okay, outermost orbit, how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 electrons, 4 electrons. So see here, it is about carbon. So carbon is a non-metal, and it is, configuration is 6, and the electronic configuration is 6, sorry, atomic number is 6 means the electronic configuration is 2 and 4. Why 2, 4? Because the first orbit must be 2 electrons, so it is stable, and after 2 electrons, we remains 4 electrons, so that is in the second orbit. So that is total capacity of the second orbit or outermost orbit, okay, that last orbit, that is 8 actually, but we have only 4 electrons, so I have put it as 4 here, okay. So one rule we know about that, doublet here, okay, octet rule, okay, one rule we know about the octet rule. What is the octet rule? So we learn in the octet rule in the 9th standard is, the octet rule state that for stability, okay, if an element is said to be stable only when the outermost orbit must be 8 electrons. That is what the octet rule, in this, so the outermost orbit, if the element, okay, the element said to be attain stability, okay, stability if the outermost orbit have how many electrons? 8 electrons. The outermost orbit or last orbit, that is 8 electrons are must, that is called octet rule. What if doublet rule is there? Okay, doublet rule may be having 2 electrons, but 2 electrons possible here because of you have 2, 4 electrons. So now see, according to this rule says that any element is stable. Okay, means stable means they not react with each other, not react with other elements. For example, helium, argon, krypton, these all what stable elements. Okay, stable element. Why? Because they are completely filled, they follow the octet rule. But in the case of carbon, you observe that the carbon outermost orbit 4 electron, but the doublet octet rule say that the outermost electron must be 8, then only they are stable. So according to this rule, the carbon is unstable. Okay, according to this rule, the carbon is what? The carbon element is
element is unstable. Unstable. Why? Because of presence of valence electrons in the outermost orbit.
So one question arises, how many valence electrons are there? So answer is how many valence electrons are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, total 4 valence electrons are there, right? So that is what actually very important point about the carbon, that is 4 valency, that is very important in the carbon. This 4 is very important because of that the carbon is called as, carbon is called as tetravalence element, tetra means what? 4, means 4 valence electrons. Why we called the carbon a tetravalency? Why we called carbon is tetravalency? So answer is because the carbon having 4 valence electron in the outermost orbit, that is why the carbon is called as a tetravalence electron, that is the tetravalent of element. So why? Because of that electron configuration. So following the octet rule, so we can come and conclude that because of the presence of 4 valence electron, the carbon is not stable. So not stable meaning the carbon can be react with another carbon element or also react with the other element, that is they form the compound, they form the molecules. Okay, why? Because of it is unstable. So unstable elements only can take a part in the chemical reactions. Okay, there is no valence electron means they not take a part in the chemical reaction. Okay, in the chemical reaction the main part is electrons. If the electron valence electrons are present, then only the reaction taken place, then only the bond can be formed. So it is very important point you have to remember about the carbon. So what can I repeat it again here? So carbon is a non-metal and the element carbon symbol is C, capital C, and the atomic number of carbon is 6 and the electronic configuration 2 and 4. So if 2 and 4 means I write an atomic structure here. So this point is a nucleus, okay, and the one orbit having 2 electrons, that is completely fit. So we remain 4 electrons, so I draw another orbit. So in this orbit, as per the nail bolts, the outermost orbit might have 8 electrons. After 2, it must be 8, 8, 8, okay, so 8 electrons. But we observe that we have only 4 electrons, I put 1, 2, 3, 4. But the octet will say that the element is said to be stable then only when they have outermost orbit must be 8. But here 8 is not possible because only 4 electrons are there. That is why if the outermost orbit is not having 8 electrons, maybe it's 7, 5, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. In that case, the element is said to be unstable. So as per this rule, we observe that the outermost orbit of the carbon not having 8, having only 4 electrons. So because of 4 and less than 8, so it is unstable. So we conclude that carbon element is unstable because the presence of the valence electrons in the outermost orbit. So question is how many valence electrons? So simple, the last orbit is 4 means it is 4 valence electron. So yes, here, first orbit, second orbit, the second, this is first and second, and this second is the last orbit or final orbit or the outermost orbit. If 4 electron means there is 4 valence electrons. Okay, because of this 4 valence electron, so carbon having 4 valence electron, because of that the carbon is called as a tetravalency. So carbon having what? Tetravalency. Okay, that is very important. Why carbon is called as tetravalency? Simple answer. Why the carbon is called tetravalency? The simple answer is because of carbon having 4 valence electron in the outermost orbit. Okay, the answer is the presence of the 4 valence electron in the outermost orbit. That is why it is called as a tetra. Tetra means 4. Tetravalency. So there is student one point about the carbon, right? So we know that carbon having unstable, so it can be form the bond with another elements or itself. Okay, maybe form the molecules or maybe form the molecules of the another elements. Okay, so hope you understand this basic points, introduction. So let us start with another very important point here. So about bonding of the carbon. Okay, bonding in carbon. So take down these four notes. So pause the video and write down these all points. Right. I now remove it one. So the next title is, write down, bonding in carbon. Okay, the next point is bonding in carbon. Bonding in carbon.
bonding in carbon.
So in that metal and non-metal chapter, we are learn about the formation of SID act here. We know about the formation of the bond between metal and non-metal. Which bonding that is one? Metal and non-metal. So metal and non-metal, we observe that when metal is reacts with the non-metal, we follow the bond formation takes place. So which type of bond there is? There is transfer of electrons are there. Which type of?
Transfer of electrons. Transfer of electrons
from metal to non-metal. The bond is formed.
Okay, bond is formed.
And the bond name is what? Right, that is what? Ionic bond. Ionic bond. Okay, in this bond what happened? In what happened means the metal what donate the electrons and it received the electrons. Right? Metal can donate the electrons and the non-metal can receive the electrons. Because of that we have plus and minus symbol on the top of the element. So for example we write sodium Na plus and Cl minus. Why? Because of sodium is a metal which can donate the electron and the Cl is an element non-metal can accept the electron because of minus. So that is what when one element donate and one element accept, that what happened? The bond formation taken place. That bond is called as an ionic bond, which we read in the metal and non-metal chapter. In that chapter we are learned about the formation of NaCl and FgCl2, okay, by the transfer of electrons. Okay, metal donate the electron and non-metal can accept the electron. That is what one thing in the chemistry, it is ionic bond. This is okay, transpiration takes place. Now let us come here in the case of carbon. Carbon also can form the bonding. Okay, here metal and non-metal between bonding is ionic bonding. Okay, the bond between metal and non-metal. Which type of bond? That is what? Ionic bond. What is ionic bond? Transfer of electrons is called ionic bond. Okay, that is bond between metals and non-metals. But here, which type of bond is formed by the carbon with the other elements? Okay, so carbon forms the bond with the carbon itself, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen and so on. Okay, so they form the bond with other carbon form the bond with other elements. So which type of bond is there? It is ionic bond or maybe different type of bond. So let us see here. So there is one point is here. See here, we know that the configuration of the carbon, that is 2,4, because of the atomic number is 6. Okay, so now see, for formation of bonding the outermost electron must be stable, means it must be 8 electrons. But see here, it is 4 electrons. So if they form the bond with the other elements, means what? It required more 4 electrons. Right? More 4 electrons, it can gain more 4 electron more. Then what happened? It is 4 plus 4 total 8. If carbon having 4 electrons, then other element must be give the 4 electron to the carbon. Then what happened? Carbon is now 8, so it is get stability. Right? But the carbon does not gain. Okay, carbon not form C minus 4 ions. That is very important. C minus 4 means it does not accept the electron. Okay, so actually when any element accept the electron, they get minus sign. Okay, so as per the theory here, we observe that the carbon does not form C minus 4. So minus 3, they does not gain electron. If they gain 4 electron, means what happened? 4 plus 4, it is 8 stable, but it is not possible in the case of carbon. It is transformation is not takes place in the case of carbon. Okay, if any element is there that transfer 4 electron to the carbon and the carbon take that 4 electron and the total 8 electrons, but that mechanism is not followed in the case of carbon. So carbon does not accept 4 electrons. Why?
Because of the answer is carbon does not form C minus ions. Why? So because the nucleus of carbon does not have capacity to hold extra 4 electrons.
See here, the carbon nucleus has capacity. Okay, that is extraction. Okay, so the extraction capacity, that this is the nucleus and this nucleus having 2 electrons
and then outermost is 4 electrons.
And this nucleus has only power to maintain these 6 electrons only. They not having the more capacity to extra 4 electrons. Okay, only 6 electrons holding capacity having this nucleus. And if they take, if they escape extra 4 electrons, what happen? Extra 4 electrons, if they leave, the capacity of the nucleus not, if they more, will accept the extra 4 electrons. So, total how many electrons? It is having 4 electrons, 6 electrons plus another, if you accept another 4 electrons, means total 10 electrons. So, the 10 electrons are the more electrons which are not be handled by the nucleus of the carbon. So, because of that, the carbon, the nucleus of the carbon does not have the capacity, does not have the power to hold the extra 4 electrons. So, total 10 electrons. Because of that, it does not form Cl minus, C minus, okay? Means the carbon does not gain the electron, okay? That therefore, carbon does not gain the extra electrons. That is very important. It does not gain the extra electrons. Because of that, the transformation is failed here. So, because of that, the acceptance of the electrons is failed here. So, if they does not accept the electrons, maybe he donated the electron. If see, if carbon can lose 4 electrons, what happened? 2 means it's stable. So, if the carbon can lose 4 electrons, then the carbon gets stability. But that also be not done by the carbon. Okay. It is not be possible to lose all 4 electrons from the outermost orbit. Okay. So, next point is, third, second point is, carbon does not form. Okay. Does not form C plus ions. C plus means what? C plus means it is giving. Okay. Does not donate. Okay. So, here, large amount of energy is required to lose or donate 4 electrons. Okay, if the carbon can use these 4 electrons, it is get stability too, but it does not possible because of the large amount of energy required, that is does not possible. So that is why it does not form C plus ions also. So that is, student, very important. We learn in this video that is carbon does not form C minus and does not form C plus. C minus means accept the electron, C plus means donate the electron. Okay, so C minus means they accept the electron. So if they accept 4 electrons, it can 8, so it gets stable, but the extra 4 electrons it does not hold by the nucleus. So because of that, it does not follow C minus. Okay, so it does not also form C plus, means donate the electron, donate the 4 electron, we get 2, means stable, but this also not possible because large amount of energy required for to lose the 4 electrons. So in both the cases, transfer is not taken place, donate is not taken place, and accept also not taken place. So the carbon does not accept electron and does not donate the electron. Then if they does not accept the electron, if they does not donate the electron, then one question arises, how it form the bond? Because the formation of the ionic bond, the condition is there. Maybe one accept the electron or maybe they donate the electron. But the both cases is failed here. They does not accept the electron and they does not donate the electron. Then question arises, they how they form the electron, how they form the bond, because we will learn about the bonding in carbon. So bonding in carbon required this process, ionic bond, one may be accept or one may be donate, but both the case are failure. So one mechanism is arises here. So because of that condition, or because of the carbon does not donate, okay, the carbon does not accept. Because of that, the carbon does not form the ionic bond. Okay, so right here, so one point, very important point, we write here. Carbon does not accept the electron, accept or donate the electron. Why? Because of the both two conditions. Okay,
electrons. So it does not form the which type of ion bond? Ionic bond. Ionic bond. So in examination they may ask
why the carbon does not form the ionic bond with the other elements. Okay, why the carbon does not form the bond with the other elements or itself?
Why? Because of it does not donate the electron or does not accept electron.
If it donate the electron, okay, it is possible that form the ionic compound. If they accept the electron, that is also possible to find the bond. But the both cases are cancelled. They not accept, they not donate. So there is mechanism of the ionic state here. So ionic bond is not formed in the case of carbon. So let us start the new bonding which are followed by the carbon to form the bond with the other elements. So right here, so that bonding is called as, okay, that is called as which type of bonding?
Right, that is what, the covalent bond. Covalent bond. Okay, so what is covalent bond? Covalent bond is a bond, is a chemical bond, is a chemical bond formed by the
transfer of electrons.
But it is the chemical bond formed by the sharing of electrons. Electrons between the elements.
And that is special followed by the carbon. Okay. All carbon compounds that is follow this rule. Okay. All carbon compounds are formed by the covalent bond, having covalent bond. So in this chapter, we are half of the chapter we learn about the covalent bond, students. Okay. So here the covalent bond, I think what the covalent bond is a bond which is formed by the sharing of electrons. Okay, that is what the elements. See, between the elements. And not only carbon, some elements are there. For example, hydrogen is there. Okay, see here, which element follow this one? Okay, hydrogen can form the this type of hydrogen follow this type of bonding. Nitrogen can follow this type of bonding. Carbon can follow this type of bonding. Oxygen can follow this type of bonding, students. Okay, so how it is taken place? We are one by one we form the H2 molecule, N2 molecule. C2 molecules, carbon oxide, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and then oxygen molecule. Okay, one by one we see how it is transfer sharing is needs. Okay, what is the sharing of electrons? Okay, so one thing they see here, why the compound not form ionic bond, we learn here because of the not form the C plus or not form the Cl. Because of that, it does not follow ionic bond. So new bonding is there in the place of carbon. That is what the bonding, covalent bond. So what is covalent bond? It is a chemical bond formed by the sharing of electron between the elements. And not only carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, carbon and oxygen also can follow covalent bond, also can form the covalent bond with each other. Okay, so one by one write it. So write down first, but learn about transfer, okay, sharing. How the sharing taken place, right? So sharing is taken place in order to maintain the stability of maybe 2 electrons or maybe 8 electrons, right? If outermost orbit having 2 electrons, it is stable. If outermost having 2-8 electrons, it is also stable. So for first one, formation of, very important, formation of H2 molecule. Okay, H2 molecule. So see, we know that how to write H2 molecule. We write H2 molecule like that. Okay, like that. And this is the thing about the covalent bond. This is the thing about, student, covalent bond. If this is covalent bond, so how this is covalent bond formed? By sharing of electron. That is very important. By share. Sharing of electron means this hydrogen and this hydrogen share the electrons to get the H2 molecule. Okay. Whenever the covalent compound is there between the element, means that nothing but not the sharing of electrons. Sharing of electrons. Okay, right here. Sharing of electrons. How it is possible? See here. We know about the atomic number of. Okay. Atomic number of hydrogen. Right. So what is the atomic number of hydrogen? Hydrogen. Yes. Right. This one. One. Okay. One means atomic number also one. So see here. Right here. This is the hydrogen. And hydrogen having only one valence electron. Right, hydrogen only one valence electron, and here two hydrogen means here one hydrogen. Okay, right here I can be Okay, this is one. Now, this another hydrogen having one electron. Okay, only one electron. Hydrogen element having only one electron. So, this is one hydrogen element, only one electron, valence electron, and one valence electron. So, now see, it is having only one, it is having only one. If here 2 means what happened? It is stable. If the outermost orbit electron may be 2 or may be 8. 8 is not possible, 2 is possible here. Okay. If this hydrogen having 1 electron more means it is 2, it is stable. So that is why CS sharing is this hydrogen share 1 electron with this hydrogen. That is sharing. Okay? This hydrogen having 1 electron and they take another 1 electron from this. That is sharing. So now this electron, this hydrogen can take 1 electron from that hydrogen. So what happened here? Sharing is taken place. See here, for this circle, we observe that this hydrogen having 1 and 2. So it is stable. And this hydrogen having how much? See, 1 and 2. That is a stable. So that is sharing. Means what? This hydrogen share 1 electron to this one, and this hydrogen can share 1 electron to this one. So because of say sharing 1 electron, so what happened here? Single bond is formed. Which type of bond? Single bond is formed. Why? Because of sharing of 1 electron. 1 electron by each element. Each hydrogen element. So because of this hydrogen 1 electron, so 1 electron more requirements, it is shared with this one. So sharing. So what happened here? This one give the 1 electron to this hydrogen, and this hydrogen give the 1 electron to this hydrogen. Sharing is taken place. This is a diagram of sharing. So only 1 electron share means it is single bond. So because of sharing of 1 electron by the each element, therefore single bond. Okay, single bond. Because of that, we write the hydrogen like that. Okay, like that, one line. So this is what H2 molecule. Okay, molecule like the element of bond between same element. Okay, this is what the covalent bond between sharing of electron taken place. So this is what, student, the formation of H2 molecule. So that is one more question. Write the formation of H2 molecule with electron dot structure. With this called as an electron dot structure. Okay, the electron dot structure of hydrogen H2 is, hydrogen molecule is, electron dot structure of H2 molecule is, that is, this is the answer. Okay, simple one. Write the electron configuration of is one topmost. So one electron, so we can write this. So observe that this hydrogen having 2 electrons, the 1, 2, and this hydrogen 2, 1, 2. So one sharing is there. So one shared by this one and one shared by this one, total 2, 2 electrons. So what happened? Because of sharing of only one electron, there is single bond. Okay, student. So this is what the number one formation of a hydrogen bond. So please write down this one. Okay, that is the dot structure. Now let us come to the next formation of another one. Another one, that is, I take another example of oxygen. Okay, that is what O2. Oxygen molecule, O2 molecule. That is called electron dot structure of O2 molecule. So first one, I write atomic configuration. So atomic number of oxygen is how much? It is 60. It is how much? It is 60. Okay, 16 means what is electron configuration? 2, 8, 6, right? 2, 8, 6. So see here, first 2, second orbit 8, 10, and last orbit 16. Again, it is what? Unstable. Okay, 6. So right here, the 2 oxygen. So 1 oxygen and 1 oxygen. Right? Next. So yes, how many electrons are there? Outermost 6 electrons. Okay, this one we write. 6 electrons. Outermost orbit, 3 orbits are there. Outermost third orbit is the outermost orbit, last orbit. So how much 6 electrons? So I write here 1 electron, 2 electron, 3, 4. So I write here. Okay. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, total 6 electrons. So I write here, this also having 6, 1. Because of O2, 2 times of O. Okay. 1 electron, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So see here. I can write here for convenience, okay, for sharing. So observe that here, so this oxygen having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means it having further 2 electrons to complete 8 electrons, okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so this oxygen share 2 electrons with this one, okay, that is one.
sharing takes place. So this oxygen can share the two electrons of that oxygen. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total completed. Now this other share 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this get two electrons of this orbital. So write T C here. So this electron share their two electron to this carbon oxygen, sorry, and this oxygen can share their two electron to this oxygen. So what happens here? Total, this is a circle of this carbon. So 1, 2 oxygen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, right? So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this what? Okay, see here, one electron and two electrons are sharing. So what happened here? If one electron share means one bond, two electron share means two bond. Okay, see, 1, 2 electron share by this two electron. So what happened? Two bond form. So that is what, the O2. That is we write as O2. Okay, this is what the dot structure of oxygen molecule, O2 molecule. Simple students. So that is nothing but what, the covalent bond. So which type of bond it is? It is covalent bond. Why? Because of sharing of two electrons are there. Why double bond? Because of two electrons are shared. Why double bond? Because of two electrons are shared. Okay, because of two electrons shared, it having the two bonds. So this is, student, the other very important point of the formation of the dot structure of the electron dot structure of oxygen molecule. So please write this one. So I can take the last of this one piece, okay, last one of this video. I can take another one molecule, that is about I can take N2 molecule. Okay, I take N2 molecule, that is N2 nothing but water, nitrogen. And the nitrogen atomic number is 7, students. Okay, the atomic number of nitrogen is how much? 7. Okay, the atomic number of the nitrogen is 7. So I write here, so I remove this one. So now see, the N2 means the molecule of same element. So I can change the configuration here. So N2 means how much? See here, it is 2 and next 5. Okay, configuration 2, first orbit, second 2, total 7. 2, 5, total 7. So now N2 means here, see, I can write here N2, okay, N, and another N. Another N. Now, see how many electrons are there present out of 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Next to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct? Now I can write like that. For convenience, I can write here this side. Okay, here I can take a 1, 2, 3. So total 5 because of writing simply. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, right? So like that. So see here, how many outermost orbit 5 is there? So how many required now? More 3 required. So see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. So this nitrogen can share this electron with this one. Okay, see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this is shared with this one. And this also having 8 electrons. So this nitrogen having 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what happens here? N. How many electrons are shared? 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron is 3 bond. 1 electron, 2 electron, and 3 electrons. So right, total 3 bond. Okay, triple bond. Triple bond. Why triple bond? Because of 3 electrons are shared. 3 electrons in a way is shared. So that is why we write, that is what, N2. N2 having how many electrons? That is 3 bond. Okay, N2 having 3 bond. So see, today we learned that H2, that is having single bond. Why single bond? Because sharing of 1 electron. And oxygen, that is having which type of bond? O, double bond O. That is why double bond, because 2 electrons sharing. The nitrogen having N, triple bond N, because of 3 nitrogen, 3 electrons are sharing. So student, this is all about the formation of the N2 molecule and the H2 molecule and the O2 molecule. So here all we can know about that, how they form the compound. Okay, so in the carbon sharing also we take in the next class. Okay, formation sharing of carbon in the next class. So we can take
in the next class about that. But in this class, we observe how the sharing takes place. So we take example of hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. How the sharing of electron taken place? Okay, that is nothing but the covalent bond. If that much that type of sharing taken place between the elements means that sharing is formed the which type of bond? That is what covalent bond. So we can define the covalent bond nothing but the bond which can be formed by the sharing of the electron between the two elements. So student, this is all about today's class. So hope you understand all the concepts of these carbonates compounds and what is the mean carbon, non-metal, their symbol, atomic number, the valency of carbon is 4, why it is 4, and why it is called as a tetravalency, and how what is the shape, how it is formed the bonding, why it does not follow the ionic bond, okay, why it does not form the C-4, why it does not form the C+. So all the concept and how the formation of sharing bond, formation of covalent bond is taking place, how the sharing of electrons actually taken place, we take 3 examples today here. Okay, so practice this one, it is very important examination for 1 month, 2 months. Okay, so thank you for watching today's video. In the next video, we come to the very important points of this chapter, that is about the carbon-centered compounds and carbon form the compound with the hydrogen. Okay, that is hydrocarbon compounds in the next class. Okay, so thank you for watching this video and like the video, share the video and subscribe the channel if you are new, and then meet in the next video. Okay, again, thank you very much.